Most Airtable pipelines fall apart because they're not built with scalability in mind. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to put together a proper Airtable sales pipeline that includes all of the vital elements and is automation ready for your organization. Now, I have built over the years hundreds, if not thousands, of Airtable solutions, and I am excited to show you what actually works in this video. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and this is Gap Consulting. It's my mission here to help you unlock the full potential of no-code tools like Airtable. And in this video, we're going to be taking a look at what is actually working in 2025 for Airtable sales pipelines. Before I get into the heart of things, though, I first do want to invite you to join me for some templates. My team has put together 5 key templates so that you can get up and running quickly in Airtable. If you're new to the software, or perhaps you've been using it forever and you just need some new inspiration, grab our free templates at gapconsulting.io/templates. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen here, and we are going to start with the database design. Before we ever build something in Airtable, it's always a good idea to wrap our heads around what different sets of data we have that are going to be interacting. So let's kind of define what these different data sets are and how they are connected. So we've got our companies here, and the companies are going to be the different organizations that we are interacting with. And of course, companies are related somehow to contacts, which we'll get into in just a moment. But contacts are the people that we know at the company, and it could be more than one person at any given company that we're interacting with. And in fact, we could know several people at a company and be working on multiple different deals across different departments and different sections of the company. So we're going to have the deals, that's the third table here, but these deals really come into play based on inquiries. And so what I've done here is I've set up the 4 different data sets that we need for a solid sales pipeline, and I've built a little visual diagram for myself to tell me how many times are they connecting to this other thing. So for example, we have 2 options that we're using. Either there's a single connection or a multi-connection. The single connection just has the 1/ here, right next to the endpoint. And then this one has the multi-connection, has kind of the 3-pronged approach here after the endpoint. So what does this mean? We can look at this and understand that a contact can submit multiple inquiries. So we see that the line between contacts and inquiries has the multiple or the many symbol here, suggesting that multiple inquiries can be connected to one contact. But if we go back the other direction on this line, inquiries to contacts, there's only one, meaning that an inquiry is submitted by one contact. You know, when an inquiry is submitted, like if we have a form on our website, multiple people aren't filling that out. It's usually one person who's filling it out and saying, I am submitting this. And this is really important for us to understand when we put this together, because when we are building that that database, we need to know how many things are connected to what and how it's all interrelating. So this is how we can represent that visually. And this is usually a really good place to start, especially if you're new to database building. This will help you wrap your mind around what it is you're creating. But now it's time for us to actually build the database backend, and then also to build the interface that our team can work from. Well, how can we do this quickly and efficiently? Well, it shouldn't come as a big surprise that I would love to lean into some AI here. So what I've done is I've built an AI chatbot and given it specific instructions. Basically, this chatbot's job is to help me output a database schema design. And this is going to save me tons of time on the back end because I won't have to go in and manually create all these things. I can just have the schema built for me from AI, and then I can use that schema design that AI outputs for me, and I'll use it in my Airtable co-builder, which you'll see in just a moment. So what I've done here is I've already just pre-filled this with a little bit of information, but I want to highlight a couple of things. Whenever we're using AI, I want you to be conscious of the fact that we can ask it for help. If you don't have all the answers, feel free to tell AI that, and I've done that in my prompt. But let's start at the top. So number one, we're saying, hey, I'm building a sales pipeline and I've already identified these tables. And these are the tables that we drew up in our database design. And then I'm also able to share with the chatbot exactly what it is that I'm building in my connections. So I'm saying, look, companies are connecting to one or more contacts, and they connect to one or more deals, right? The part that I'm not sure about, though, if we go back to our database schema, is the link between inquiries and deals. So when an inquiry comes in, does it automatically create a deal? Does it always connect to a deal? Or do we only create a deal when an inquiry moves to a certain stage? There's so many pieces of this that, you know, for our example here, I'm not really clear on. So I want to get that clarity from the bot. So I've called that out in particular in my prompt here. And this is an important thing that I would suggest you lean into whenever you're interacting with AI. The parts that you don't know, highlight them and call them out, and you'll get better answers from your prompts. And then down here, I also say, please ask me questions about what my data set or workflow is in order for you to recommend the best schema. So that's the first step, right? And I'm going to send this message in and I'm going to get this input back, or this output rather. And so here it's saying, hey, what's the relationship between inquiries and deals? Does an inquiry lead to a deal, or are inquiries more like a general interest where deals are negotiations? So let's answer these questions. And of course, this is just an example. And for your particular use case, your exact business needs, this might be a little different. That is the beauty of Airtable and leveraging AI to build it, because you can really quickly spin up your own example that fits your needs. But for our example here, let's suppose that deals are negotiations and inquiries are more general. Then we can say, in question two, ChatGPT is asking, should an inquiry be able to link to multiple deals or just one deal? And let's say I think an inquiry will only link to one deal. And then we can say, for deals, are you tracking different stages? Absolutely. We definitely need to use this, the different stages of the deals, so that we can see where things are in our pipeline. So I'll say, absolutely, we need to track stages for deals. And then the last question that it's asking, are inquiries more like one-off events? Someone fills out a form. Yes, inquiries are one-off events. And again, this is just my own example that we're putting together here. Whatever you are building in your Airtable for your specific organizational needs, it's going to be different. And that's the beauty of these tools. They give us that kind of flexibility. So I'm going to send that message through, and ChatGPT, just like that, says, cool, this is the data schema that I envision. And this is great. It's just coming up in a matter of moments. So now I can take this, I'll ask it to open Canvas. And this is going to allow me to copy it out much more easily. So this whole thing is just getting recreated in Canvas. If I need to make any edits, I can. So I can just highlight some pieces and edit them. But I like it. I think this is just fine. I'm sure we could do a little bit of light tweaking, but let's roll with it. We're going to grab it right here, copy this to our clipboard, and pop on into Airtable now. Now, because I have AI toggled on for my workspace, this is a paid workspace, I'm using AI, I have that turned on. It costs a little bit more with Airtable, sure, but I think you'll agree what I'm about to show you right here is going to really streamline your organizational processes if you're building a lot of databases. So especially among consultants like myself, I see AI used a lot. If I'm in a workspace that is not using AI, so let's say, for example, I'm in Airtable Universe here, I don't get that same option here. So my two options have changed, but I'll go back to my Gap Consulting option where I have the advanced AI turned on and I have build an app with AI. I will make that selection, and all I have to do is drop in the schema that was suggested from our custom GPT. I just dropped it in right here, and we'll hit next. We can actually choose a color first. Let's go with this nice, what is this, teal? We'll go with that. We have settings here. We can give it a name, audience, etc. I usually don't worry about that all too much when I'm building, and I just say generate the app. And you can see right now, Airtable is thinking about it. It's putting it together. And because we did such a good job labeling out our different tables, telling it what different fields we have inside of those tables, etc., we have this amazing output. So just like that, it's put this app together. We can kind of poke around in the demo elements of it and see where we're at. Pretty cool. So let's just assume that we like it. We'll say create the app, and it's going to create this CRM type application. Now, while it's doing that, I will say that almost every project we work on for our clients has some CRM element to it. Every business is different, as we've said multiple times. But of course, with Airtable always needing some sort of CRM element, we can still then go back on the back end and customize all the other pieces or components of that. So if we say edit app now, this app has been generated. I'll close down all the pop-ups here, and we'll go to edit the app. And first, I like to go back to the database and just see what's back here, because I still think in database in rows and columns, because this is the original version of Airtable that I grew to love. So we've got the companies here, linked to contacts, linked to inquiries, linked to deals. Everything perfectly, right? If we come over here, we'll see that we got the different fields that we requested, but Airtable's AI almost always plugs in some extra fields that we did not ask for because it's really leaning into the AI components. I can't fault Airtable for this, but at the same time, if I wanted this field, I would have asked the co-builder for it because I kind of know what I'm doing. So here we go. I'm going to highlight these and just get rid of them. We could go through and do that for all of our different tables. This is, of course, going to tweak our interfaces, the front end component, because that was also built for us. So we'll have to go back into our interface and make some updates. I find that a little bit frustrating, but in the grand scheme of things, this saved us how many hours? And it's all done for us right here. So I can go now to interfaces. And of course, I have some sample data here that was we saw here on the back end in the database. And that's just here so that we can kind of play around and make sure that we like the application. Let's give it a publish, and we could share it with our team if we were ready to do so. I'm not. This is just an example. So we'll just kind of poke around here. We'll see what it built for us. Now, we have the lovely AI assistant that is kind of in beta right now, brand new stuff. If you're lucky enough to have access to this, you can plug this in and talk to AI, ask it to add things to your database, ask it to analyze the data. This is insanely powerful. We're not going to leverage it for our current example right now, but know that it's there, giving you amazing functionality with Airtable. But here we are. We've got companies. I can add a company. This is going to pop open a form. This was all built for us by the AI. I could make these fields required. I could say test co. And just create this new company. Beautiful. Right here, I have inline editing. I can add new contacts here, or if I need to, actually create new contacts in my database, I can flip into contacts and add them here. So this is giving us the flexibility between companies and contacts that we were describing earlier. It's very common that we will be doing work for multiple different deals, multiple different inquiries for the same organization across different contacts. So this is a valuable thing for us to build for a scalable solution. Inquiries are over here. So we can imagine that people are filling out inquiries and they are coming in through our website, perhaps through a form. We could build an Airtable form for that. Or if we wanted some more robust form features, we could leverage a different form tool like a fill out, a jot form, something along those lines. Once that form is created, we can wire it so that the new form submissions plug right into our database, and we can create the companies, we can create the contacts, we can create the inquiries, all based on that form submission. And then ultimately, what happens? Well, an inquiry is going to reach the right stage where we escalate it to a deal, and then we are going to track the amount of the deal, take it through various stages. Of course, that deal is assigned to a company in contacts and very likely an inquiry as well. And we can see that in a Kanban view as well. So we can just bring these pieces across. The interface is highly intuitive. We can click into these records. They pop open. We can make edits. And as you can see, those two AI generated fields that I deleted are missing. So we'll have to do a little bit of tweaking before we go live. But this is what I would recommend for your sales pipeline. Having Kanban views for your deals, for your inquiries, properly connecting that data to your contacts and to your companies. This is a scalable solution that you can take and grow in a sales team. I hope you got a ton of value from the video. Of course, if there are questions we did not address here, feel free to swing by our website and grab some help. If you got value from this, we would love it if you could give us a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, but most importantly, keep on building.